Good evening, peoples. Right, I'm just going to do a few bits and pieces, and I'm just changing a few batteries, so I just thought I'd show you as well. Look at this. Another day. Another strap. Goodness bloody me. These are very difficult to find, these straps, for this is an ATC 1000. It's a lovely watch. I'll show you the alarm feature. Pretty cool, isn't it? Gotta love a bit of Casio. It's got a rotating bezel as well. Look at that. Snapped. Just like that. Never mind. That's the life of a Casio collector. Right, I just thought I'd show you this. I don't think I've featured this before on this channel. I did have a few of these. One was in absolute brand new condition. Never used, and someone made me a really good offer for it, so I took it. But I've got another one, and this is the sort of box they come in, the cream box. And and you know what it is? It's almost, well, it is the same thing. One's a silver. I did a video of this the other day. One's a silver one, and one's a black one. I prefer the black one than the silver one. And it's just the same features as the other watch. And I just thought I'd show you. I was scouring. I don't know if you've been on this website before. This is like the old, in the UK, we have Casio. In the UK, we have Argos catalogues, which are almost coming to an end now. And I just thought I'd show you. There's that watch there, look. This is a 1988. And this is what it said about it. It said, number 4? Oh, I can't even read it. Let's zoom in. Number 4, it said, Casio Chrono Alarm World Time Visual Local City Display World Map. Features normal time, month, date, motor time. What is it? What's it say there? 29 independent world time zones with fast search facility, stopwatch, split time, countdown timer, water resistant. And it was $14.95. Let's get this zoom back on this one. Ding. £14.95 that was. And next to it is this one here, which is this one on there. And what, how much was that one? Let's have a look. That was $16.95. same sort of thing. And as we're on this page, where's that watch? I'm going to show you this one here somewhere. Here there it is. There's that one, which is it, number 6, and that was £3.99 then. £12.45. Bargain. And we have this one here, number 1. How much was that? £24.95. See there? And we got the one next to it as well, which was this one here. And that was number 2, $24.95. What else we got here? That's it. I've got all these, by the way. They're in the display cabinet. How much was that one there as it goes? Number 13. Where's 13? $29.95. So out of all the ones I showed you, that's the most expensive. How much is this one here? 12. 20 quid? 20 quid? Bargain! Oh, that was a... How much is that one? 14. I bet that's expensive. God, 60 quid for that? When you think that was 14 nights, so you could buy 4 of them for the price of that. That one's a DBX 100. And I've got a brand new one of them in the box. I showed you the other day, didn't I? That's the one I had done a video of the other day. I've got this one. I've got all these watches here. Amazing. I should have put them all on here as displayed like that. It'd be really cool. But I've only just got this out as last minute. Yeah, it's quite nice, this watch, isn't it? Pretty nice. I just want to show you something quickly. So I was doing some battery changing today. And I just thought I'd give you some little insight. So I changed, is it this one? This one. I changed the battery on this one here. And so I buy lots of job lots. So there could be loads of other watches, maybe 30 other watches of all sorts, not Casio, but there could be one in there that I like, and that's the Casio, and that's all I wanted. So I have to buy the whole job lot just to buy that one Casio. So sometimes I'm left with stuff I don't really want. So this one was part of a job lot. Now I changed the battery and nothing happened, and it wasn't working, so it wasn't ticking. I put a new battery in it. But to know whether your module is gone or the hands are just jammed, best way to find out is using one of these. Now these are pretty cheap. I've got my hands on crazy. So what you do is you turn it on, and here will be a pulse. So I'm going to show you with this. I'm going to show you another watch what I mean. So let's use this Timex one, for example. So it's ticking. See it? When I put it on here, you see what happens there? As it's ticking, it gives you a pulse of the seconds. So it shows that it's working. So if I take it off, obviously there's no beep. And this Casio here, it's not working, but I don't know if the module is broken or not. So what I'm gonna put on here and have a look. So that's telling me that the module is working and it's ticking. It's just these hands are just jammed. Now you can unjam the hands, and the way you do it is you put it on this side of this machine. But these hands are so jammed that it's not even moving the hands. And that, I have never seen that before. But I'm just going to show you what it means. I've not put a battery on this one yet. But if we flip this switch, I'll show you how to change the hands. So watch. Watch the hands move. And he does it with a little... You see the hands move like that? And what you're doing there is you're unjamming the hands. And you can go forward or backwards. That's a good tool. But this is the first time it's happened. I've changed the battery and I put this one on here and the hands. Oh! It is the first time that's moved. DL. Jesus, that wasn't working before. And that's how it's done. You unjam the hands. Sometimes you've got to leave it on there. I can't even believe that's working. Oh, stopped again. Let's try that again. Yeah, see, this stopped again. They must get jammed in a certain position. Yeah, I'll play around with that later. But you get the gist, what I'm on about. Let's turn that off. It's a good little machine to have if you do a bit of repairs, because that will tell you what's pulsing, and that will tell you, it will just jam the hands up for you. It's worked every single time, except for this time on this watch. What was I going to say? Oh yeah, look, I'm sorting all these watches out here in this box. And, these are the CMD40s I'm going to start getting rid of. Got to change the battery on this one. What we got in here? Probably some bits I've showed you before. We got an AE20. Oh, look, that's that one up there, I think. Is it that? Oh, yeah, let me show you this quickly. Look. if we just go back a page. See that one there? It's that one. How much was that? Number one. Diddle-dee-dee. No, where's number one? God knows. By the way, I got a jumble a lot the other day, job lot, and it had one of these in its box. No one's ever opened it. It was quite good to see, and obviously someone see it online and bought it off me. Yeah, just sorting this box out. Loads of bits to sort out in here. You see one of these before? This is very rare. This is CFS 80. Very thin. Look how thin that is. See this here? When I was in 1993, this is the first Casio that I bought for myself. I got a little part-time job, and I went and got myself one of these. I'm going to go on the catalogue. If you go on these catalogues, they're called Argos. Romash, I think it's called. If you just type in on Google old Argos catalogues, it will come up as the first one on Google, and you can go through any years, even the late 70s up to present day, I think. But I just check the years that I like, just check the Casio watches. Yeah, don't even remember these sort of watches. That's pretty cool. You've got a flat keypad as well. What else we got in here? Another CMD. A little Timex there. What's this? Oh yeah, showed you that the other day. When I got this, by the way, this wasn't working. I left the batteries in there and it just fired it up itself. What was it here? Just zoom in. Just a little quick video. Nothing else to say, I don't think. I wasn't going to do a video tonight because I had to sort a few things out. Oh, there's stuff on here. What's this? Got so many of these lying around. Yeah. Should we turn this on? Look. Can you see that? Let me zoom in. I'll zoom in on the Casio box. Oh no, let's zoom in on here on the screen. It's got, oh bloody hell. So, where's the camera? Clock, oh my God. Yep, that's the best we can do, I'm afraid, for this black and white camera. Yeah, this came out in the 2000s, very early 2000s. First camera on your wrist, except if you were James Bond, of course. But yeah, pretty cool, isn't it? And you just capture the images. Have I done a video of this? Of course, I've got a brand new one up there in the box. There's this one here. I'm gonna try and source another one of these. I was actually blown away when I first got one of these and how amazing these watches are with the solar system. Have I shown you this? Look at this. Watch this. Let me show you this. So if I click alarm. Now I'm going to press the alarm button and you're going to see a shooting star come from the top here running through both screens like this angle here. So I'm going to press the side button here and hopefully get ready to see it. Ready? I'm going to press it now. See the shooting star? So cool, isn't it? Unfortunately, this screen has got like a little burn here on the screen, which is such a shame. But to get a really lovely one of these, you'd be spending a lot of money. But I'm going to be on the hunt to look for one. I actually bought this one. It was a spares or repair online. The guy said it wasn't working. He took it to the jewelers, put a battery in there. When it arrived to me, it was working. So, pretty good touch. But I bought it quite cheap because he thought it wasn't working, you see. But it just arrived working. But unfortunately, it's got a burn mark in there. And it's pretty scratched. But it's such a great watch, though. It's the first time I had one of these. Quite blown away with it. The things that you can do. Let me show you, look. So this is... let me just go here. I think it's this button here. Watch the solar system on top. You see the planets going around the sun. I'm fast forwarding now. Sorry. You can fast forward to any date. Amazing, isn't it? It's a shame the screen's like that, because if it wasn't, it'd be so much more clearer. And I'll probably wear this every day. If I can find another screen, I'll get it changed. But it's pretty scratched. And for the sake of, I don't know, I think it's probably worth 250, maybe £300. I don't know. We'll see. Might keep it. But oh, look. Look what I'm wearing today. Absolutely love this watch. The CMD40, one of these. It's my very first watch, my favourite watch. But coming to realise how amazing design this watch is, just the colours and goodness me. I've got a new strap for this coming, because obviously, as it always goes, the original one broke. So I put this other Casio one on when it arrives, and it should arrive maybe this week, beginning of next week. When it arrives, I'll do a full video of what this watch does, and it's amazing. It's got a scanner on it there. You press the button on the bottom, and it could just scan any temperature. It does a radiation heat of anything. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Any comments or suggestions or tips, put them down below. I'll answer every single message. Cheers. Thanks for watching.